Hey, New City Kids!
Welcome back to another amazing Sunday. My name is Alyssa.
And I'm Kenzie, and we're so excited that you decided to join us online today.
We are. We have so much in store for you this morning.
That's right. But first, let's start with our New City Kids values.
Okay, New City Kids, time for our values.
Here at New City Kids, we have 5 values, and our values is what's most important to us. They help us each day to be more like Jesus.
Our first value is love God. Do you know why we love God?
Great question. We love God because God first loved us.
It is so great how much God loves us.
Absolutely. Can you tell us our second value?
Our second value is love people.
We love people because God loves all people.
All right, our third value is do your best.
Do you know why we can do our best?
Because when we do our best, God does the rest.
I love that. Now, can you tell us our fourth value?
Our fourth value is be generous.
When we're generous, we have helping hands.
Exactly. I love to help.
Absolutely, me too. Do you want to do the fifth value together?
Yes.
Okay. Our last but not least value is
choose joy.
We can choose joy because God gives us joy.
Absolutely. And we can have a positive attitude.
Exactly. Great job. Those are all 5 of our New City Kids values.
Now let's worship together.
Becoming obedient to the point of death.
It's Memory Verse time! And I am so excited for this Sunday because we are learning a new memory verse.
That's right. Alyssa, do you know where we can find our memory verse in the Bible?
That's a great question, Kenzie, and I do. You can find this week's memory verse in the book of John in chapter 11, verse 25.
Thank you. All right, juniors and all-stars, you know the drill. I'll say your memory verse once so you can learn it, and then I'll say it again so we can all say it together. All right. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life." John 11, 25. All right, let's say it all together. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life." John 11, 25.
Great job, juniors and all-stars, and make sure you keep practicing at home.
On the third day after Jesus' death, Mary Magdalene went to Jesus' tomb. It was still dark, and she saw that the large stone at the entrance had been moved away. Mary ran to Simon Peter and John. "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and I don't know where they have put him," she said.
Oh.
Peter and John ran to the tomb. John looked inside and saw the linen clothes lying there. Then Peter went into the tomb and saw the linen clothes too. The cloth that had been around Jesus' head was folded up. John believed that Jesus was alive. Then Peter and John went back home. Mary went back to the tomb and cried. When she looked inside, she saw two angels sitting there. They said to her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "Because they've taken away my Lord, and I don't know where they've put him," she said. Then Mary turned around. Jesus stood in front of her, but she did not recognize him. Jesus said, "Woman, why are you crying? Who are you looking for?" Mary thought Jesus might be the gardener. She replied, "Sir, if you have taken Jesus away, tell me where you've put him, and I will go get him." Jesus said, "Mary." Mary realized who he was and said, "Teacher." Jesus sent Mary to tell the other disciples that he was going back to the Father. Mary did what Jesus said, and she told the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." Meanwhile, some of the guards from Jesus' tomb went into the city and told the religious leaders everything that had happened. The leaders got together and made a plan. They gave the soldiers a lot of money and told them to lie about what they saw. "Say that Jesus' disciples came in the night and stole his body while you were sleeping," they said. The guards took the money and lied about Jesus' resurrection. Jesus died on the cross for our sins, but he didn't stay dead. God was pleased with Jesus' sacrifice and raised Jesus from the dead to reign as King over all creation. Jesus provides salvation from sin and the promise of eternal life.
Wow, today we found out the second part of our story.
Jesus is alive.
Now that is the best news ever.
It is. God raised Jesus from the dead to be King over everything.
And he tells us that when we trust in him, he rescues us and promises that we'll get to live with him forever.
Now let's learn our story point and big picture question.
Great idea.
Thanks. Our story point for today is, Jesus rose from the dead and is alive.
That's right. And our big picture question asks, where is Jesus now? Jesus is in heaven.
Wow, what a great Bible story today.
That's right. All right, juniors and all-stars, let's pray together. Go ahead and fold your hands and bow your heads. Dear God, thank you that Jesus did not stay dead. Thank you that we can win over death and sin because of Jesus. Help us to trust you and obey you and love each day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Have a great day, New City kids. We will see you next week. And always remember,
Jesus loves you, and so do we.
Bye.